Nothing is impossible. And so we can see some pictures on the board. Can you explain to us what these pictures are showing?
This picture is the good morning sticker we put around the horse's neck. There you can see how the sticker looks around the horse's neck. This is a photo of my horse at 120 kilometers. He ran like he has not even ran 1 kilometer. He was so strong, my hands got sore from holding him back. This is a photo with us with our trophies. And here you can see the Emmanuel TV shirt I had on during the race with my national colors from Namibia.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Now we can see that you are carrying an award in that picture. Can you explain to us what that award is?
At this race, I got prizes for coming second, as well as my national team won. And because of the good riding I did, I was the Namibian Rider of the Year.
Let us put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Can see the award. She was awarded the Namibian Rider of the Year as a result of the endurance race that she participated in. All right, well, let's hear from your father. You're very welcome, sir, to the Synagogue Church of All Nations. Tell us your name, where you're from, and who the people are standing beside you.
Emmanuel. Good morning, brothers and sisters. It's indeed a privilege for us to be here this morning. We come from Namibia. It's a very dry country. We're going through a severe drought at the moment, so it was really difficult for us and a testing to be here this morning, but it's indeed a big privilege for us. We must thank the Lord for being here this morning, and also for the man of God for welcoming us and having us here. It's really, it's for us indeed. Thank you very much.
Praise the Lord. Share with us your wonderful testimony.
Yeah, the race that we went to a while ago, was the African Endurance Championship that was in Walvis Bay in the Namib Desert. The Namib Desert is one of the oldest deserts in the world, and my son-in-law and my daughter was chosen for the Namibian heavyweight team to compete. And we were quite excited about it because we knew we had two horses in the race. The one could help the other one, and that could give us a great chance of winning the race. Susan, my daughter, has got a lot of experience. Her husband, Charles, is a newcomer to the sport, but it was his second race after his novice phase, so indeed it was a challenge. He never covered the distance. So coming into the race, it was tough. At about 100 kilometers, Susan, we picked up problems with her horse, and she had to fall back, and Charles was given the instruction to go for it. So at the last 10 kilometers, I said to him, Shal, now is the time to attack. We've got to attack the opposition because our horse haven't got a very good sprint, but the opposition is a much stronger and they got a very good sprint. So attack and go. And I was looking at the guy, and he was smiling, the opposition guy was smiling at us, and he knew he had us, but at least we tried. And off Shal went, and that was the last 5 kilometers. The last 10 kilometers had a loop, and as he came back, there was 5 kilometers back. They were together, and as he was approaching us, I knew I had no more plans, and I realized. But I got morning water with me in my pocket. I took out my morning water, and I had a bucket of water, and I put the water into the bucket. And I know through Philippians 4 verse 13 said, through Christ all things is possible. And I knew this one, with anointing water and with the Lord Jesus, we're going to do it. And as he was approaching me, I threw the water over him, and all of a sudden this water just changed completely, and he started galloping at a fast trot, and he left. And the opposition got on his horse and challenged him, and it so happened that he beat him by over a minute.
Let us put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So our father just explained that his son-in-law participated in the African Endurance Championships, a race of over 100 kilometers long. And when his son-in-law participated in the race with about 10 kilometers to go, the father-in-law gave him the heads up to start running because the opposition horse is a very good finisher. So when the other horse was, his horse was trying to race as best as he could, the horse started to get tired. And so the father-in-law now remembered that he had the morning water with him. And so he put the morning water in a bucket, and as his son-in-law's horse was coming by, he poured the morning water on the horse and on the rider, and all of a sudden the horse began to run like it never did before and won the race by 1 minute. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Okay, let's hear from the son. You're very welcome. Please tell us your name, where you're from, and your testimony.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Charles Smith from Namibia. I was the rider in the Endurance African Championship in Walvisbaai on the horse that won the race by a miracle. The last 10 kilometers of the race was very hard. The horse got tired, and I got tired motivating the horse. And it was a tough race. I tried my best to keep the horse motivated, but eventually I started to lose hope in the story. And then at the last 5 kilometers, my father-in-law took a bucket filled with morning water and threw it over me and the horse, and the horse just took control and started running towards the end. It was amazing.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. And so now you are the winner of the African Endurance Championship title, is that right?
Yes, that is right.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus. So can you just share with us the picture, explain to us the pictures that we can see on the board here?
This is a picture during the race. I can't remember where exactly it was, but yeah, it was a tough race. As you can see, the good morning sticker on the horse's neck, that helped with the motivation. And this is the photo they've taken for the newspaper of our country. And this is me with the trophy that I won, and the best condition trophy the horse also won on the race. And thank God, it was amazing.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Okay, let's hear from Susan. So finally, can you share with us, what is your advice for viewers over the world?
My advice for viewers over the world is God can make the impossible possible, because both of these races, it was impossible for my horse to compete even in that race. With only 19 days of training, a horse is not able to run that far, nevertheless that fast. And if you believe in God and use your good morning water and sticker in faith, God can make the impossible possible.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Yes, with God all things are possible, and He makes the impossible possible.
Vous venez d'écouter ce magnifique témoignage de cette famille qui vient de la Namibie. Ils ont pris la parole pour expliquer que quand ils sont venus ici, surtout la femme, quand elle est venue ici pour la dernière fois, l'homme de Dieu lui a demandé qu'est-ce qu'elle voulait faire. Elle a dit qu'elle voulait participer à une course de chevaux, et l'homme de Dieu l'a sponsorisée à hauteur de 3 000 $ pour participer à cette course. En rentrant chez elle, elle a pu rentrer avec également l'eau du matin qu'elle a appliquée sur son cheval. Elle avait un cheval qui ne pouvait plus courir, qui ne pouvait plus marcher depuis 4 longues années. Et pour la gloire de Dieu, elle a expliqué qu'en seulement 19 jours, son cheval a retrouvé toute sa forme et s'est retrouvé en parfaite condition pour participer à une course internationale de chevaux contre plus de 200 autres cavaliers sur une distance de 120 km. Et pour la gloire de Dieu, elle a gagné cette course. Ils ont gagné cette course. Et ils ont expliqué qu'au dernier tour, durant la course, le père ici présent a mis l'eau du matin dans un seau d'eau qui a ensuite déversé sur le cheval et le cavalier. Et ils ont expliqué qu'à ce moment-là, le cheval lui-même s'est mis à courir comme jamais vers la ligne d'arrivée. Et c'est comme ça qu'ils ont gagné la course. Ils ont même été déclarés cavalier de l'année pour leur pays, la Namibie. Et En conclusion, il remercie Dieu pour ce miracle et cette magnifique victoire. Il conseille à tous de mettre votre confiance en Dieu qui peut faire de l'impossible possible.
Escuchamos este otro grandioso testimonio de esta familia que viene desde Namibia. Ellos tienen, son propietarios de un campo de entrenamiento de caballos de competencia. Ella nos cuenta que en una oportunidad que tuvo de venir a la sinagoga iglesia de todas las naciones, tuvo la gracia de poder reunirse con el hombre de Dios, y el hombre de Dios le habló acerca de que ella iba a participar con sus caballos en competencias internacionales, y él la patrocinó con $3,000. Dice que al regresar a su país, efectivamente decidió participar en el campeonato africano de competencia de caballos, pero dice que el caballo que habían elegido para competir de repente enfermó. Tuvo una enfermedad que por esa razón suelen sacrificar al animal porque no tiene cura. Ella dice que en el nombre de Jesucristo, al recibir el agua de la mañana por parte del hombre de Dios, se la ministró al caballo y además también puso sobre el caballo la calcomanía de la mañana. Dice que también milagrosamente el caballo se recuperó y pudo participar de esta competencia y fue el ganador del galardón. Ella le da toda la gloria a Jesucristo, y junto a su hermano y su padre cuentan que otro caballo que compitió en una actividad de velocidad, dice que el caballo estaba compitiendo y cuando empezó a sentirse cansado, el jinete, que es el hermano, decidió ministrar en ese momento el agua de la mañana, y como un catalizador el caballo pudo correr más, ganó la competencia con una diferencia de 1 minuto sobre 300 caballos más. Ellos le dan toda la gloria a Jesucristo y dicen que lo posible puede ser posible a través del nombre de Jesucristo, por medio del agua de la mañana y la calcomanía de la mañana. Continuamos.
And before calling on the person concerned to come forward, we're going to watch the screens of our television and see how that miracle happened here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations. So let's pay attention to our screen right now and see what God Almighty did.
Observe su pantalla, vamos a ver el video de la siguiente sanidad que ocurrió en la semana pasada en la Sinagoga Iglesia de Todas las Naciones.
Les témoignages continuent. Dans quelques instants, vous écouterez le témoignage d'une personne qui va édifier votre foi. Continuez à regarder et que Dieu vous bénisse.
imagine being totally unable to see anything at all. What a torture it must be, as this man is led forward at the Synagogue Church of All Nations by a lady. It is obvious that he has a problem with his sight. He gropes for a chair and tentatively lowers himself into it. Let us hear from Mr. Ruben Wosu, who has come to the church with the problem of blindness.
My name's Wosu Osita Ruben. I came from Imo State, on Imo local government precisely.
Can you tell us exactly the problem that brought you to the Synagogue Church of All Nations today?
It is a problem of blindness. It was on the 5th of April. I loaded my motor from Mazamaza, conveying the passengers to Aba Port Harcourt. When I climbed the bridge, the road was dividing. I was seeing double. I could not see again. Immediately I match brake automatically on the highway. By the time this thing happened, I called my wife, called my elder brother, Mr. Chief Linus Mwosu, who is living in London with the wife. He said I should leave that hospital immediately, enter night's bus, come back to Lagos and go to Prophet T.B. Joshua. I believe and have faith that I will be cured here.
I will pray with you that the Lord Jesus Christ will set you free today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
My name is Mrs. Wilson.
Where do you come from?
Imo State.
Okay, the man sitting next to you, who is it to you?
He's my husband.
Okay, tell us, what is the problem that brought your husband to the Synagogue Church of All Nations today?
My husband is blind now. He's on the driving before the incident came on the highway. He called me on the phone to tell me that he cannot drive again. He's not seeing. As he called me, I was very shocked. I don't know what to say. But at a stage, we have been to two hospitals. He called his brother and explained everything to his brother. His brother told him that he will come to T.B. Joshua, the place that he believed that he will call him. And that is why we are here. We have that hope that from when the man of God see him, he will be healed.
Mr. Ruben Osita Nwosu is led to the prayer line by his wife during the Synagogue Church of All Nations Monday service, holding a placard for all to see that he has the problem of blindness and is booked for an operation. All his faith and hope is in Jesus Christ, the compassionate healer of our wounds.
Help me, man of God, help me, man of God. My husband is blind, he cannot see.
Man of God, help me. Help me, man of God. My brother in London sent me to come and receive my healing here. I cannot see. I booked for operation and I'm blind now. I cannot see.
Help me, man of God. My husband cannot see. They book operation for him and we don't want to go to the operation. Please help me. I have him. He's blind. My husband is blind. My husband, man of God, I beg, help me.
Help me, man of God. Help me, man of God.
Cet homme est aveugle. Elle crie pour que l'homme de Dieu le guérisse de la cécité. Elle est aveugle dans quelques instants et va retrouver la vue. Regardez. Gloire à Dieu. Les aveugles voient.
Yes, hombre puede ver.
I can see. Jesus, thank you.
I can see. Man of God, I can see. God bless you. Continue with the work. God bless you. God bless you. I can see now.
Maintenant qu'il voit,
I can see clear.
Il rend toute la gloire à Dieu.
I thank Jesus. My name is Mr. Ruben Osita Nwosu.
What is the problem that brought you here?
Blindness. I was moving on the highway. All of a sudden, I couldn't see. Man of God approached me and touched my eye. I can see now.
My eye cleared. I can equally drive my motor now.
Yeah?
I am seeing people lining up.
What's the color of that mountain?
This is milk color. This is milk color. This one is red, a small boy. This one black and white and blue. This is man of God in my front.
Hallelujah!
This is man of God in my front.
Let's clap for wonderful Jesus Christ.
So right now the people concerned are here in our midst and they want to share their testimony. Let's put our hands together for Jesus. Indeed, as it was, so it is. The anointing of old we read about in the Bible, the time of blind Bartimaeus, the healing that happened, the anointing is still very much available here in the presence of God. So we're going to listen to this wonderful testimony right now.
Vamos a escuchar el testimonio de este hombre que junto a su esposa vinieron porque él tenía un problema de ceguera donde de repente él quedó ciego después de estar conduciendo en una autopista. La semana pasada durante el servicio en vivo, el hombre de Dios oró por él y él recibió su vista nuevamente. El Señor restauró su visión en el nombre de Jesucristo.
Nous avons vu cet homme qui était venu avec un problème de cécité, il était complètement aveugle et il est venu chercher le secours de Dieu. On a vu comment l'homme de Dieu, le prophète Josué, a prié pour lui et comment le miracle s'est accompli. Maintenant, il voit clairement. Nous allons l'écouter dans quelques instants.
Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ one more time. Now, just before we listen to this incredible testimony, I know our viewers around the world may not necessarily have been paying so much attention just earlier when we played the clip. Some of us can never believe that such an incredible miracle could happen in our generation today. So before we listen to this testimony, we want to show you the clip again of what happened to this man here last week at the Synagogue Church of All Nations when he came with this problem of blindness and received prayer in the power of the Holy Spirit. So before we listen to them, let's watch our screen again and see exactly what happened here, and let's give glory to God together.
Observe su pantalla, vea este video.
Imagine being totally unable to see anything at all. What a torture it must be. As this man is led forward at the Synagogue Church of All Nations by a lady, it is obvious that he has a problem with his sight. He gropes for a chair and tentatively lowers himself into it. Let us hear from Mr. Ruben Nwosu, who has come to the church with the problem of blindness.
My name's Nwosu Osita Ruben. I came from Imo State. Onimo, local government precisely.
Can you tell us exactly the problem that brought you to the Synagogue Church of All Nations today?
It is a problem of blindness. It was on the 5th of April. I loaded my motor from Mazamaza, conveying the passengers to Aba Port Harcourt. When I climbed the bridge, the road was dividing. I was seeing double. I could not see again. Immediately, I much brake automatically on the highway. By the time this thing happened, I called my wife, called my elder brother, Mr. Chief Linus Nwosu, who is living in London with the wife. He said I should leave that hospital immediately, enter night's bus, come back to Lagos and go to Prophet T.B. Joshua. I believe and have faith that I will be cured here.
I'll pray with you that the Lord Jesus Christ will set you free today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
My name is Mrs. Nwosu.
Where do you come from?
Imo State.
Okay, the man sitting next to you, who is it to you?
He's my husband.
Okay, tell us, what is the problem that brought your husband to the Synagogue Church of All Nations today?
My husband is blind now. He's on the driving before the incident came on the highway. He called me on the phone to tell me that he cannot drive again. He's not seeing. As he called me, I was very shocked. I don't know what to say, but at a stage, we have been to two hospitals. He called his brother and explained everything to his brother. His brother told him that he will come to TB Joshua, the place that he believed that he will call him, and that is why we are here. We have that hope that from when the man of God see him, he will be healed.
Mr. Reuben Osita Nwosu is led to the prayer line by his wife during the Synagogue Church of All Nations Monday service, holding a placard for all to see that he has the problem of blindness and is booked for an operation. All his faith and hope is in Jesus Christ, the compassionate healer of our wounds.
Help me, man of God, help me, man of God. My husband is blind, he cannot see.
Man of God, help me. Help me, man of God. My brother in London sent me to come and receive my healing here. I cannot see. I booked for operation and I'm blind now. I cannot see.
Help
me, man of God. My husband cannot see. They book operation for him and we don't want to go to the operation. Please help me. Please help me. I have been. He's blind. He's blind. My husband is blind. My husband, man of God, I beg, help me. Help me. Help me. Help me.
Help me, man of God. Help me, man of God.
Cet homme est aveugle. Elle crie pour que l'homme de le grille de la cécité. Elle est aveugle dans quelques instants et va retrouver la vue. Regardez, regardez. Gloire à Dieu. Les aveugles voient.
Yes, I'm puede ver.
I can see. 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 I can see now. I can see. 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 Man of God, I can see. God bless you. Continue with the work. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I can see now.
Maintenant qu'il voit,
I can see clear.
Il rend toute la gloire à Dieu.
Thank Jesus. I thank Jesus. My name is Mr. Reuben Osita Nwosu.
What is the problem that brought you here?
Blindness. I was moving on the highway. All of a sudden, I couldn't see. Man of God approached me and touched my eye. I can see now. My eye cleared. I can equally drive my motor now. Yeah? I am seeing people lining up.
What's the color of that man wearing?
This is milk color. This is milk color. This one is red. A small boy. This one black and white and blue. This is man of God in my front.
Hallelujah!
This is man of God in my front.
Let's clap for one time for Jesus Christ.
Oh, Jesus, I thank you. Oh, I thank you. The only man in battle. I have nothing to give him. Not to say thank you. Thank you, President. Victory over this man.
Amen. One more time. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So we can see our brother walking forward by himself to the glory of God. This is the man that we saw in the clips just moment earlier who came to the Synagogue Church of All Nations with a case of complete blindness. And here he is today to share a wonderful testimony to the glory of God. So, sir, you are welcome in Jesus' name. Please tell us your name and where you are from.
Yeah. Good morning, church. Emmanuel, my name's Osita Reuben Nwosu. I am from Onimo local government, Imo State. I am working with Chisco Transport Company Limited. I drive highest bus popularly known as Hummer. I was loaded on the 5th of April to Owerri-Aba, Port Harcourt. When I moved, I was very sound. I don't have any problem. All of a sudden, by the time I was climbing that flyover at my two, heading Apapa Oshodi Express Road, it happens that the whole road was appearing to me double scattered everywhere. By the time I noticed what was happening, I tried to apply my brake automatically on the express road. The passengers were asking me, "What is happening, Mr. Nwosu?" because some of them know me. I said, "I don't know what is happening." By then, I managed to keep aside from the main road. Before I know it, it is like darkness is coming down to my eye. I couldn't see. So I quickly gave one of my passengers my phone to scroll the name of my coordinator in the company. So we parked by the side. In no distant time, we have assistance from the company. Another driver came. Everybody was surprised to see this kind of thing. People started asking questions. I was totally blind immediately. So I was shouting, "What have I done to receive this kind of thing?" I started reciting, in fact, talking to myself, "Why must I go blind?" So I asked somebody to call my wife. It is somebody who called my wife through my phone there to tell him what is going on. So some suggested that we move, instead of dropping here, we should head down to Onitsha, where I went to Nosco Eye Clinic. That's Niger Optica. My colleagues at Onitsha took me there. We met a white man doctor. He examined my eye and told me that my two eyeballs are dripping into my head. I asked him, "What does that suggest to be?" He said, "I am going blind. And the solution is to operate me. He will give me some medicine so that I can go home and prepare myself." I said, "It is not my portion. I cannot go blind." He said, "Okay." When they gave me the drugs, from there I called my wife. Somebody helped me because I was with my phone. I used to give somebody, "Please help me, find so-so-so name." Then they called my brother in London, my immediate elder brother, Chief Linus Nwosu. He lives in London. I told him what is going on. He said, what for? "I don't know." He said that I should not waste time now, that they should put me into motor and bring me back to Lagos. I should proceed to Synagogue Church of All Nations immediately. So by the time I came back through night bus, somebody took me, because they are taking me now, I don't know myself again. It's like somebody intoxicating my brain, headache, everything. So they took me to my place. My wife came to the bus stop and picked me up. We immediately proceed to Synagogue Church of All Nations. By the time I came here, I don't even
Everywhere is like I'm looking at a high sea. If I open my eye, it is like I'm looking at a bar beach. I don't perceive anything again. Nothing crosses my eye. So my wife told me, it's not something I'll be crying, people gathered, until they helped me to put me on the line to see the man of God. So they were dressing me to see man of God. I couldn't see anybody. I was shouting, man of God, help me. I have gone blind totally. For more than 5 days, blindness. So I perceive when the man of God touched my stomach, I was still shouting because I couldn't see anybody. He came back again and touched my eye. Something like wiping from my forehead to my eye. All of a sudden, I saw people. I begin to see people. I begin seeing again. So, it wasn't a surprise because I've been seeing others being healed. I have my belief and the faith that I'll be healed here. And I have gotten the healing. I am seeing now. Even the day I was coming here, I don't know the color of cloth I was wearing. That was why they washed it for me again, for me to appear, to tell the world what I saw. I am very, very delighted that I can see again.
Amen. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Now, at this point, we want to ask our question, our brother. He said just moments ago that when Prophet TB Joshua approached, of course, he was not seeing him, but he felt a hand, first of all, touch his stomach and then rub his face on four occasions. Now, sir, we want you to describe to us, what can you say about that hand that just touched you? Because definitely, before, people had also dressed your eyes. I'm sure your wife had touched your eyes. Other people, the doctors had examined it. But what can you say about that hand that just rubbed your eyes four times and you began to see? How can you describe it for us?
The hand that touched my face was so cool, quiet to my head. All of a sudden, the headaches that I was suffering disappeared. It's like when somebody woke up from slumber, open your eye and start seeing something. That is exactly what happened to me. So the hand touch was the miracle that happened.
Amen. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. With what our brother is saying, it's clear for all of us here that that was not the hand of man, it was the hand of God. And by the grace of God, I believe our brother's testimony is going to prepare you. Because by the grace of God today, that same hand is going to touch us today. And the hand of God that caused this man's blind eyes to be opened, God is going to use that same hand to touch your life today. Many of us may not know the value. We'll just be watching Emmanuel TV. We see people falling. We see miracles happen. But we don't really know the power of God that is flowing. And I believe our brother's testimony is an encouragement to you to get ready for your own touch. And we believe as you receive that touch, just as our brother's eyes were opened miraculously, in the same vein, the door to your breakthrough will be open today. The door to your healing will be open today. The door to your deliverance will be open today. As you receive that touch. If you believe that, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Glory be to God, sir. So as you received that touch, you said it's just like you woke up and your eyes were opened, you were able to see. And since then?
Yeah, since then, I've been seeing clearly. Nobody assists me again. Because I was wondering what kind of sickness is this? By having automatic eye blindness, And I was on a highway conveying lives. In fact, to God be the glory.
Wow, we thank Jesus. We can see our brother, how he walked in unaided. He's moving by himself. And to the glory of God, sir, we're seeing you actually holding a pamphlet in your hand. Can you just demonstrate your total healing by reading what's there?
Yes, I can read. This is obedience is the key.
So our brother is actually holding the sermon for today, and he's just demonstrating his complete healing.
Obedience is the key. This is the caption of this booklet. In English side, as a Christian, the only way is to feel good about yourself is to begin to believe and accept what Jesus has done for you.
Well, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. We give all the glory to God Almighty. This is indeed an undeniable evidence to testify that our brother has been completely restored through that divine touch from God Almighty that he received last week here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations. Now, we just want to listen to a quick word from your wife as well. She believes she may have one or two things to say about this wonderful miracle. So, madam, you're welcome. Can you please introduce yourself to us and tell us what you can say about the healing that your husband received?
Emmanuel, my name is Anne Kechumos, the wife of the man that gave testimony. I am here so to support him because it was very terrible for me. He cannot do anything by himself during that process. I am the one assisting him. Even when we come down from the vehicle, I am the one holding him. You know, from there to here is a very tough thing to me. But today, I am a happy woman because God has done it, which I cannot buy with money. God has done it. I say, may God, who do this to me, will answer every one of us in the name of Jesus.
Escuchamos el testimonio de este hombre que llegó a la sinagoga iglesia de todas las naciones con ceguera porque él es un conductor de profesión y mientras estaba en una autopista, él dice que un destello cegó sus ojos y a partir de ese momento no pudo ser capaz de volver a ver. Él dice que la oscuridad lo cubrió completamente y a pesar de que fue donde muchos médicos no podían descubrir esa razón, él cuenta que empezó a depender de otros y que su hermano que se encuentra por fuera del país le dijo que él tenía que venir inmediatamente a la sinagoga iglesia de todas las naciones después de haber estado buscando solución a su problema. Él dice que por fe decidió venir y la gracia de Dios lo acompañó y él pudo estar en la línea de oración y el profeta TV Joshua oró por él. Él dice que ciertamente no fue la mano del hombre, sino que fue la mano de Dios lo que lo tocó y le permitió volver a ver. Inmediatamente después de la oración del profeta TV Joshua, él dice que el dolor de cabeza que padecía se desapareció y también dice que inmediatamente fue capaz de volver a ver como observan en su pantalla. Él le da toda la gloria y la honra a Jesucristo porque dice que desde ese momento ve claramente, puede hacer sus actividades por él mismo y su esposa también da gracias a Dios por el hombre de Dios y porque Dios actuó a través de él en ese día para regresarle la vista a su esposo. Gloria a Jesucristo. Continuamos.
Gloire à Dieu, nous avons entendu un témoignage extraordinaire et merveilleux. Cet homme dit s'appelle Ruben Osita, il vient de l'état de Onitsha. Il dit qu'il était chauffeur de profession. Un jour, il conduisait son bus rempli de passagers vers le 15 avril. Alors qu'il était en route pour aller à Port-à-Côte, tout d'un coup sur la route, il a commencé à avoir une vision brouillée. Il voyait double. La route était complètement distendue devant lui. Il a paniqué, il a rangé son véhicule rapidement au bord de la route et tout d'un coup, des ténèbres ont couvert ses yeux et il ne pouvait plus rien voir du tout. Il a appelé un passager, il a donné son téléphone, a demandé à la personne de chercher un numéro quelconque de sa femme et de les avertir de ce qui se passait. Ils ont appelé la compagnie qui a envoyé un autre chauffeur.
Et immédiatement, il s'est rendu compte qu'il était complètement aveugle, il ne voyait rien du tout. Alors, il a demandé à un passager d'avertir sa famille et d'appeler son frère qui est à Londres. Son frère lui a dit, immédiatement, ne perds pas de temps, va directement à la synagogue église de toutes les nations. Là, tu trouveras la solution. Alors, il est venu accompagner sa femme ici à la synagogue, comme on l'a vu sur l'extrait vidéo. Il ne pouvait rien voir, alors on l'a rangé sur la ligne de prière. Lorsque l'homme de Dieu, le prophète Yeshua, s'est approché de lui, il l'a touché au ventre. L'homme a dit, je ne voyais personne, mais je ressentais quelqu'un me toucher. Il a touché ma tête et tout d'un coup, le mal de tête a disparu. Et tout d'un coup, cette même main a touché mes yeux. Alors immédiatement, je commence à voir clairement. Il dit, c'est comme lorsque vous vous endormez, vous ouvrez les yeux au réveil. Il a commencé à voir distinctement le Dieu des miracles et vivant. Jésus-Christ, le Seigneur, a utilisé son serviteur prophétique de Yoshua pour le guérir et le restaurer. Et aujourd'hui, il nous dit que la même main qui a ouvert ses yeux, qui ouvre les yeux des aveugles, est la même aujourd'hui qui va toucher votre vie aujourd'hui. Croyez de tout cœur et Dieu va vous visiter.
Y vamos a escuchar, a continuar escuchando este extraordinario testimonio de sanidad donde este hombre llegó a la sinagoga iglesia de todas las naciones completamente ciego y por el poder que actúa sobre el profeta Tibi Yoshua, él recibió su sanidad después de que el profeta oró por él y tocó sus ojos. Ciertamente fue la mano de Dios lo que lo tocó y él pudo recuperar su vista y dice que ahora ve claramente y le da toda la gloria y la honra a Jesucristo. Continuamos escuchando este extraordinario testimonio en el nombre de Jesús.
Listening to this incredible testimony of the gentleman here who just explained how Jesus Christ healed him from this case of total blindness through the prayer of Prophet TB Joshua last week here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations. And very shortly we're going to play back the clip again of how our brother received prayer, because there's some important areas that we want you to take note of. First and foremost, maybe you didn't see it clearly during the clip, but on the day of the prayer, Prophet TB Joshua actually passed by the brother as he was crying out, shouting for help. Prophet TB Joshua passed him by and then returned and came back and prayed for him as the Spirit of God directed. And I believe when Prophet TB Joshua comes out later today, he'll be in a position to explain more about this, why he actually passed him by before returning and praying for him again. In the same vein, in that clip, we're all a witness to how he was moving when he brought in. You could very clearly see that this was someone that could not see at all, the way his eyes were moving up and down. He had to be led even to find a seat to sit down. It was someone that actually came and assisted him just to find a seat to sit down on the prayer line on that day. His wife had to be with him 24/7. So we're just pointing out these things as an encouragement for us to know the power of God that we are under here. Once again, that hand that God Almighty used, the hand of Prophet TB Joshua, to pray for him today. I mean, our brother explained earlier that he felt, you know, like something cold, but I believe it's more than just a cold sensation that happened at that time. That was the fire and the power of God Almighty that flowed through the hand of Prophet TB Joshua to bring total healing to the life of our brother here. Because if you say it was just cold, you know, in all over the world we have our cold seasons. In Nigeria here we have Hamatan, and around the world we have winter period where people's hands are cold. So it's not just a mere coldness or cool sensation that our brother felt. It was something much more than that. It was a supernatural and spiritual touch from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Another area that we want to point out to people as well is that as our brother received prayer, we all witnessed how the Prophet TB Joshua prayed for him 4 times, moving his hand across his eyes. And when the brother stood up, it was clear that at that moment, it was like he was just beginning to see. And suddenly, as he took a step, his eyesight, his vision was returned completely. Now, this actually reminds us of a scripture, which I'm going to read to you today. This is the scripture from the book of Mark, chapter 8, from verse 22. So I want to read this to you, because what we are seeing here is a practical demonstration of what we read in the scriptures. So if you have your Bibles, viewers around the world and those present, present here, you can turn to Mark chapter 8, verse 22 to 26, and the scripture reads thus. They came to Bethsaida, and some people brought a blind man and begged Jesus to touch him. He took the blind man by the hand and led him outside the village. When he had spat on the man's eyes and put his hands on him, Jesus asked, "Do you see anything?" He looked up and said, "I see people. They look like trees walking around." One more time, Jesus put his hands on the man's eyes. Then his eyes were opened, his sight was restored, and he saw everything clearly. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. Now, we're going to play you back the clip again of when our brother received prayer, but please take notice of all of these details. You'll see that when the prophet prayed for him, he stood up. It was as if at that moment he couldn't see everything so clearly. As we read in the Bible, he was just seeing objects, and then suddenly his eyes were completely opened, and he was able to see everything. I mean, we just saw him read the sermon piece there better than many of us, even present here, can read. Some of us who are even using spectacles would not be able to read to the degree that he just read now. So this is an incredible transformation in the life of our brother. So let's play back the clip right now and just take notes of all these things, as what we are seeing today is a demonstration of what we read about in the scriptures. Because the book of Acts, the Gospels of Jesus Christ, they are not mere history books. They are the pattern of what Jesus Christ wants his church to be today. And the power of God we read about in the Bible is available and present in our midst today. And by the grace of God, that same hand that touched our brother and restored his sight, God is going to use that hand to touch your life today. So let's just watch one more time. We'll play you back the clip of how our brother received prayer. Let's watch.
Imagine being totally unable to see anything at all. What a torture it must be. As this man is led forward at the Synagogue Church of All Nations by a lady, it is obvious that he has a problem with his sight. He gropes for a chair and tentatively lowers himself into it. Let us hear from Mr. Ruben Nwosu, who has come to the church with the problem of blindness.
My name's Nwosu Osita Ruben. I came from Imo State, on Imo local government precisely.
Can you tell us exactly the problem that brought you to the Synagogue Church of All Nations today?
It is a problem of blindness. It was on the 5th of April. I loaded my motor from Mazamaza, conveying the passengers to Aba Port Harcourt. When I climbed the bridge, the road was dividing. I was seeing double. I could not see again. Immediately I mash brake automatically on the highway. By the time this thing happened, I called my wife, called my elder brother, Mr. Chief Linus Nwosu, who is living in London with the wife. He said I should leave that hospital immediately, enter night's bus, come back to Lagos and go to Prophet T.B. Joshua. I believe and have faith that I will be cured here.
I'll pray with you that the Lord Jesus Christ will set you free today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
My name is Mrs. Nwosu.
Where do you come from?
Imo State.
Okay, the man sitting next to you, who is it to you?
He's my husband.
Okay, tell us, what is the problem that brought your husband to the Synagogue Church of All Nations today?
My husband is blind now. He's on the driving before the incident came on the highway. He called me on the phone to tell me that he cannot drive again. He's not seeing. He called me, I was very shocked. I don't know what to say, but at a stage, we have been to two hospitals. He called his brother and explained everything to his brother. His brother told him that he will come to T.B. Joshua, the place that he believed that he will call him. And that is why we are here. We have that hope that when the man of God see him, he will be healed.
Mr. Ruben Ositanosu is led to the prayer line by his wife during the Synagogue Church of All Nations Monday service, holding a placard for all to see that he has the problem of blindness and is booked for an operation.